going to start with the revision of the poem, the ball poem. Okay. Actually, here in this poem, the ball represents the lost childhood of a child. When ball is lost, what it means when ball is lost? He will know the sense of loss. What it means? Yes. What it means that when the ball is lost, the child should know the sense of loss. What it means? What the poet want to say in these two lines? Yes, Keshav. Yes, ball is also a part of life. Like in life, we have faced many, many kind of losses. We face many kind of sufferings, but this doesn't mean that this is an end to our life. Okay? Go from that side. Sit down, please. Don't stand. So it means that with change in life, we have to face losses and we have to adjust ourselves and to safeguard ourselves with that sense of loss. It doesn't mean that with that loss, we will always feel lost and we always feel that life has come to an end. Okay? So with this simple example of childhood, the poet is actually delivering us that there are a number of losses that have been taken place in our life and it will go on. And it is not a fact of a single person, the life of a single person, but it is applicable to all human beings. And human beings, they must have adjusting nature so that they can understand the losses that are happening in their lives. So if we talk about the line-wise explanation of this poem, so let us see the ball poem. What is the boy now? Why has lost his ball? Okay, so what is the boy now means? In this line, what is the boy now? See here. So now it's written in twice, repetition. Yes, it is yes. It is of course yes. Can you tell me what is assonance? What is assonance? Can you tell? Huh? What is assonance? Who will tell me? Yes, Sanchita. Silence on that. Simar, you can come in this line. Come, please. Assonance is actually repetition of all sounds, means not at the starting of the word, but in between. Somewhere in the word. It is called as assonance. Simar, please come. What is the boy now who has lost his ball? What is he to do now? Now the poet is considering the condition of the boy who has lost his ball. He's thinking that what he will do now. Who has faced this kind of loss and what he will do now because something is lost in his life. So what is his loss? What is lost in his life? Huh? Belongings, okay. Mainly it is, you can say here it is also referring to childhood also, lost childhood also, right? And here, who has lost his ball? In who has lost his ball, who and lost? Again, this is an example of assonance. Okay, this is again an example of assonance. And what is he to do now? Yesterday someone was asking him anaphora. So this is here an example of anaphora. See, the first line, it is starting. What is the boy now? The second line is also starting with the same word, what? Okay, so when the same word phrase or group of words, they are starting the same next consecutive lines, it is used. So this is an example of anaphora. Vanshika, you got to know what is anaphora? I repeated two times. Still I'm repeating. See here, in the first line, see, the line is starting with what? The next line is again starting with what? It means there is repetition of word in next line. Okay? So this is called as anaphora. Huh? Assonance is who lost. And for first line is boy now. There is repetition of WW. So this is also example of assonance. Right? This can also be an example of assonance. Yes? What anaphora? What complete is anaphora? Okay. I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street. So what the poet is imagining? So I see it merrily going down the street. Stand up from here. Stand up. I don't want noise near me. Stand up, you. Yes, go there, please. Or go with that girl. So now, I saw it go merrily bouncing down the street. So what the poet is saying that I have seen the ball going bouncing. So here, you remember the literary device you say, I saw it merrily go bouncing down the street. No. Imagery, right? Imagery is used here. Because when we read this line, I saw it merrily go bouncing down the street, then ultimately what is there? Then an image is created in our mind. When an image is created in our mind, so this is which literary device? This is called as imagery. And then merrily over there, it is in the water. So from down the street where it has gone, near some water where there is some, you can say some part of stagnant water is there. And again, Vineet Roop, yes, tell me. The third line is merrily bouncing down the street. And next line is, and then merrily over there is in the water. Which literary device? Huh? Metaphor? What is a metaphor, beta? No one will speak. Let me ask. What is metaphor, Vineet? Kiti, what is metaphor? Can you give any example? Sit down, please. Please sit down. Don't talk while anything is going on in the class. It doesn't mean, huh? Merrily, it is anaphora again. It's anaphora again. Huh? When actually, when repetition is, of course, you're right. It's a repetition of words. But when it is starting the line, the words are repeating, then the name is given as anaphora. Okay, we don't deny this fact that it is, you can say, repetition. But actually, because it is starting the ability, because it is present at the starting of two different or consecutive lines, so we can call it as anaphora. Right? To do? Yes, you can call it as an ens. Yes. Okay? But still, I feel that you people are not so equipped with complete knowledge. I thought that you people have prepared at once and you people were cribbing, ma'am, paper ho gaye. Why again? Now I think so that of course there is a need. So that you can go through it thoroughly. You haven't gone through it thoroughly to the chapters. Merrily bouncing down the street and then merrily over there it is in the water. Now what the poet is saying that now after jumping the ball from the street, where it has gone now, it has gone into the water from where the poet or you can say the small child is not able to retrieve it back, to get it back. No use to say, oh, there are other balls. But the poet is saying that there is no use of saying to this young child, don't worry, if your one ball is gone, you will get another. Because the another ball that he will get, it will never replace the first loss that has occurred in his life. Okay? It means that the poet is saying that there is no use of soothing the child or consoling the child that he should not feel sorry for the loss of the ball. Because if one ball is lost, this doesn't mean that he will get another one in place of it. He will get something else, but that will not compensate the loss that has been made because of the first ball. This is the reason he thought that there is no need of consoling the child. An ultimate shaking grief fixes the boy. The boy is now filled with complete sadness. Grief means sadness. He is engulfed in complete sadness because he is feeling very bad. He is fretting over the loss of the ball. As he stands rigid, trembling, staring down. So what was the condition of the boy? This is the general condition of every person that when a person faces any kind of loss in his life, he will feel grief-stricken, he will feel shattered, he will feel broken. And the same condition is of the boy. He stands rigid. Rigid means without any sort of any emotion, without any kind of emotion, he was standing there, trembling, he was shaking. Why? He was shaking because of the situation that loss has occurred in his life. And moreover, staring down, he was just looking in front of him that what has happened. Prapreet, yes, stand up. What we have read in the poem till now? Sit down, please. Thank you. Next one. All his young days into the harbor wear. Okay. So now what the poet is saying? Poet is saying that all his memories of his young boyhood days, okay, they have gone into that harbor. Harbor means it has been lost in the expanse of life. Okay. They have been lost. All his young days, they have gone away. Okay. Right? It means that all his memories of his young days, they have gone away. His ball went. I would not intrude on him. He has lost that ball. Which ball? Loss of his childhood memories. It has been lost. But the poet is saying, I would not intrude on him. I would not interfere. I would not interfere on the feelings of the child, because the poet says that the child should himself understand the sense of loss. He should understand the actuality of loss, that losses or the things which are lost, they are a part of life. And we need to compensate ourselves. A dime. Okay, dime is? It's US money. Okay, dime, small amount of money. A dime. A dime, another ball is worthless. If he will give small amount of money to a child, he will get another ball, but that is worthless. I told you, because the ball he will get in place of this ball, it will not compensate the loss of the first ball. Okay, why it will not compensate the loss of the first ball? It is because of the reason that, of course, he will get another ball, but that ball would not, you can say, compensate the loss that has been made by the first ball. Okay. So, a dime, another ball is worthless. Now he senses first responsibility. Now the poet is saying that the boy should first learn his responsibility towards life. That these kind of losses, or they are actually, you can say, part of our life. We face these kind of losses. And because of these losses, a person always learns something from his or her life. Right? So, in a world of possessions, people will take balls, balls will be lost always, and little boy. So, in a world of possessions means here, when we own different things, in this materialistic world, okay, people will have different kind of balls. Here, balls refers to different kind of relations, responsibilities, the things with which we are attached. Okay, there can be different meanings of these balls. And here, balls, repetition it is. Okay, and they will be lost always. So nothing is permanent in life. It doesn't mean that if one ball is lost or one ball, it remains forever with us in our life. Okay, there will be some changes. A person will get a loss, or a person will face a loss. And ultimately, in place of it, he will get another ball. So, and no one buys a ball back. And no one means the same ball is not bought again, because in place of this, something else is the person gets. Right? Yes, the person gets something else. Right? There are different memories. Money is external. So this is very important point. You are talking again and again. So money is external. What is the meaning of this, that money is external? Very important point here in the poem. That, yes, very good. It means that money cannot buy everything.
It means that with money we can't buy everything. Okay, money can bring materialistic things, but money cannot bring your belongings back. Okay, the sense of belongingness we never get. It cannot bring back your relations. He's learning well behind. Yes, ball back is example of alliteration. Ball back is example of alliteration. Buys a ball back is alliteration. He is learning well behind his desperate eyes. In behind and desperate and eyes. There is predominance of sound E. Now it is assonance. Okay. He is learning well behind his desperate eyes. Behind his desperate eyes, which he want to get. Okay, ball back. He is learning the actual strategy of life. He is actually learning what actually life is. Or what actually the rule of life is. He is learning this. The epistemology of laws. Okay. Epistemology means nature of laws. Okay. Actually, epistemology is actually a Greek word. From where this word has been derived. Okay. Epistemology, it means that he should sense the nature of laws first. How to stand up. How to stand up means how to overcome that sense of laws. How he would be able to overcome that sense of loss, and knowing what every man must know, one day know, and knowing means that every man in his life will one day come to know this reality of life. Okay, that every person in life, he will come to know about this reality of life, that losses, they are a part of our life. We have different kind of losses. We face different kind of losses. Some are with materialistic things, some are with our, you can say, relations also, but that doesn't mean an end to our life. Okay, it means that we should understand that these losses are part of our life. We need to adjust with these losses in our life also. Nature of loss. Likha hua hai, okay, understanding nature of loss. And most know many days how to stand up. It means that the poet is highlighting the harsh reality of life. That means how to stand up against odds in life. Okay. How to stand up against the, you can say, against miseries of life that happen in our life. How to overcome that loss. Yes, alliteration is used here. Second last line. So this is an example of this alliteration. So ultimately what the poet wants to deliver us is that one should understand the sense of loss, and losses are part of life we face, but this doesn't mean an end to our life. We need to overcome that kind of loss and we need to learn out of it. Right? So clear this now? Any doubt in this poem? So let me ask few questions to you. Nahin, here we can't say, see, as hai, an hai, all hai. In this manner, AA, no. It cannot be anything. In a line. Okay? Oxymoron is mein nahin hai. Oxymoron, like when opposite is given, jaise kal karwaya tha, quiet rage. Rage is anger. Anger is otherwise furious feeling. It cannot be a silent one, but with that adjective, quiet is used. That is oxymoron. Okay? Okay, let me ask. He senses first responsibility, and what responsibility is referred here? Which responsibility is referred here in the poem? He senses first responsibility. Yes, Samarth, you said, ma'am. I mean, which responsibility he is talking about? Okay, this is just one part. Okay. Taking care of things, we can say. Okay, but he should understand the sense of loss. Okay, how to stand up after the loss. So So this is the main thing, okay, that he need not to be consoled. So why did the poet not console the boy? Yes, Krishna, you can give the answer, because you were very anxious to answer in between, hai na, trying to talk again and again. Why did the poet not console the boy? Sit down. Yes. Akhilesh. Because he wanted to make him realize the loss is a part of life, of course. Okay, sit down. Because he wanted to make him realize that loss is a part of life and one should overcome this loss by oneself. No one will help a person to come out. Sit down. Yes, please. Why does the poet not decide not to give money to the boy, or he should buy another ball for him? Yes, it will not replace the first one. It will not be the same one. Though he will get the new one, okay, but that will not compensate for the loss that has been made earlier in his life. Okay. Money is external. This you know now. We cannot buy everything with money. Next. What does the lost ball metaphorically stands for? What does the lost ball metaphorically stand for? Yes, what does the lost ball metaphorically stand for? What does it stand for? Loss of childhood. You know, suppose in MCQ you are given responsibilities be optional, loss of childhood be hai. You will take the loss of childhood. Okay, because since starting, I'm telling you in the poem, loss of childhood, loss of childhood, loss of childhood. It has gone to an harbor. Harbor means, harbor refers to the complete life. It is lost means it was just a part of life which has been lost. Okay. So in the next class, we are going to discuss about Anne Frank. Yes, it will be given.